mutable objects in Python. So what is the mutable object, guys? The objects which allows you to modify the contents of that object. Those objects are called as mutable object, mutable objects. So we can create two different mutable objects with the same value or data or content. Okay, fine. So what is my intention? Let me create the paint again. I want to create a list. So list is a sequence of elements, guys. Okay, fine. So this is my memory location. Fine, one more list. This is my second memory location, second object. In one object, let me create a, let me store some values like 10, 20, 30. So what is the purpose of collection objects? So this list is a collection object, na? So you can store different values, multiple values in a single objects. So let me have this copy and paste. So here also let me store now. Okay, 10, 20, 30. Let me add here. So here is 20. And here is 30, guys. Here also let me create now. 10, 20, and here is 30. So I took two different variables of their memory locations. So here is my x. I want to create list. So you can create this list by using simply square brackets. You can create a list by using simply square brackets. Set curly braces. One more is parentheses. Yeah. Okay, we'll see. So it's 10. What are the values that are present? In x, 10, 20, 30. Okay, and this is y. Assembly operator, let me use the square brackets. 10 here also, 20 also, and here is 30. Can you see here? So x is pointing to this memory location. And y is pointing to this memory location. Okay, boss, fine. So let me, I want to get this program for the same. Now let me write the program where I can create the two different lists. So how to create the list? Like array you can call, like array. So go to Python shell. Should I close this one? Close. File menu, new window. Now here, I took a variable called x, 10, 20, 30. Okay, this is x tuple. If you want to print, you can simply print x, file, save. Where should I save? List.py. Hey, list is predefined keyword, na? Okay, let me create mutable.py, hit the save. Now let's print by using F5. Can you see a 10, 20, 30 at last? 10, 20, 30? Okay, fine, guys. So let me create the same one more list by using Y. Before creating one more list Y, let me show you what is type. What is the type? How can I use print type of x, and if you want to see the id, what will you do? Print id of x. Okay boss, fine. Print type of x, id of x. Now same I want to create for
y.
Yaar me save na karta close kela. It happens guys, this silly mistake happens. Let me open mutable na? Okay, last time I saved this much only. Let me save once again. Print so here let me give the type of x. Let me print now. Print id of x. Okay, let me have the same issue. Kai close ka hota automatically again. Second time guys, not second, third time. It should not happen. Open mutable. Okay, this time I don't go shortcuts, I'll use menu buttons. Print of type of x, let me print the id of x. Same, let me print control c control v. Let me keep the variable as a y. Let me print the value of y. Here is y, type is y, and let me show you the id. So this is not mutable, so this is not a immutable, but this is the mutable. Okay, when you print now, file menu, save, run module. Now see here, 4875368 and id is 4891752. So both are mutable na, even the values are same, even the values are same guys. So this is my intention, is to show mutable and immutable. Okay boss, fine. Now from this same program I want to receive only one item or two items or three items. How can I receive, or how can I place that value, how can I change the value? Mutable means the value could be changeable, value could be able to modify.
Yes.
not only by using address, also I want to change the values. So how can I change? Now let me go to my program in Python shell. It's my Python na? So this is first position, second position, third position. Let me print now. Okay, otherwise let me take one different program. Control A, Control C, file, new window, Control V. Okay, now here I don't want to go. Otherwise let me add some values guys. Let me add some values here. So x is a list. On the first position I want to replace with some other different values, and let me show you by using print whether it is modified or not guys. Fine, and same let me show you here. Save, mutable, modify, some different name I want to give, that's it. Hit the save button, saved. Hit the F5, run button. Now you can see here guys, first time 10, 20, 30, 0 index, first index, second index, 10 as it is. I try to modify first index, what is that value? 123. It is able to modify na?
Yes,
able to modify or not?
Yes.
So value is modified now. Value is modified guys. So let me give you some of the points on this mutable and immutable. mutable and immutable for your understanding sake. So what are the points, guys? What are the predefined classes and objects which are immutable? List is there, set and dictionary classes, objects. Dictionary class objects are mutable objects by default. As compared with the immutable objects, mutable object performance is low because which allows to modify as well as this does not share the same memory locations. So applying the iterations on mutable objects, it's somewhat time consuming. Guys. Set, comma list, comma dictionaries, class objects, classes objects are mutable objects. Okay boss, so mutable objects performance. Object performance is low when compared to immutable objects. Next, applying iterations. Applying iterations on mutable objects takes more time. Okay boss, now next let us see string handling. Let's work with now string handling.